found our YouTube channel. Just go to our church website, mentonechurch.org, and you will see the information there. We're going to go right into our program. We have a lot of things, as you can see from your bulletin, but I just have a couple of announcements today. The first thing is that we are living at a time where we have a wonderful opportunity to do evangelism. A lot of people are interested in the Hacksaw Ridge movie, and so we have set up a website where people can get a free book on Desmond Doss. There's a lot of business cards that are in the foyer. Take a stack, pass them out far and wide, and people can then request a free copy of that book. We've already had many people take advantage of that, so just take some of those cards. The other thing, we have just a bit of church business to do today. So church members, listen up carefully. It's the second reading for the officers for the next 2 years at Mentone. Last year, there was the first reading, and this week you should have received a piece of paper with the updated list of officers for that. And so today is the day for the vote. Is there a motion that we accept the report as we have it printed for you today? Is there a motion? There's a motion. A second. And a second. Motion and a second. All right. All in favor of adopting this starting January 1, 2017, please say amen. Amen. Okay, that's good. I heard a pretty good response. So you were listening well. Well, thank you again for being here at Mentone. Again, today is a very special opportunity to come together. I'd like for us to pause right now for our invocation. So please bow your heads with me as we pray. Heavenly Father, we are so thankful that we can come to you today on your holy Sabbath. We want to uplift Jesus Christ. This is our goal, for we know that if he is lifted up, all people will be drawn, and our hearts have been touched, and so we are thankful for the opportunity. Please be with us, guide us, and encourage us, we pray in Jesus' name, amen. At this time, we are going to continue our service with the collection of our tithes and offering. So if the deacons will prepare for that, I just want to... Okay, they're just having to do a little more setup. You know, this has been an exciting music program to prepare for. Last night we had our rehearsals starting at 3 p.m. is when my wife and I first got here, and we had groups. You can see that we have almost as many musicians as we have people in the audience. Isn't that exciting? So they're just setting up a few more things. So let me tell you a little bit about the different offerings that we do have for today. Those of you who've come to Mentone for the last few weeks, you notice that we do not have our Christmas tree with us here at on the stage. It's there in the foyer, but please do not put any gifts on that tree today. If you would like to give anything for the Christmas offering, we encourage you just to put it in an offering envelope. Let me tell you a little bit about the Christmas offering for those of you who might be visiting here at Mentone today. We have four projects that we are specifically focused on, and the funds will be divided among these four projects. The first project is for the sponsorship of five medical missionaries in the country of India. The funds that will be collected will go to sponsor those five workers for an entire year. And so please be praying for that. India is a very challenging field at this current time. So we're praying that the money will be used to advance the gospel there. The second project that we are going to help is the Seventh-day Adventist Church project called Total Member Involvement. We have several of our own members here at Mentone that will be going to Romania next year in February, all right? And we have the opportunity to be part of a joint effort with the General Conference of Seventh-day Adventists to advance the gospel through preaching. So that's the second project. The third one is the Adventist Learning Center in Lebanon. That is a wonderful project that is reaching out in a very challenging part of the world. And the fourth project is to improve the lighting in our church. As many of you know, LLBN will be broadcasting our service. We need improved lighting. It's not good to see some people up here standing on the stage with only half their face lit or shadows or whatever. So we're going to improve our lighting through those projects. We also, of course, today, the offering will go toward the local church budget. Mentone is a very active church. Internationally, we've already talked about several things, but locally, we are active as well. So the local offering goes to facilitate lots of different projects as we seek to reach out into the community that is all around us. People are in great need. We're looking forward to a lot of new projects in 2017. One of those is something that you want to mark on your calendar, and that is our evangelistic effort with evangelist Taj Pakhlib. He's going to be coming in mid-February and March. You see the dates in your bulletin there. So we encourage you to give faithfully toward these different projects. God has blessed, and we are excited that we can share the blessings of God with the world around us. Daniel, are we ready? Praise the Lord. Let's bow our heads and ask a special blessing upon this offering, that it will go far and wide to the benefit of God's cause. Heavenly Father, we are so thankful we can praise you in music and in song. And I ask that you will bless what we give today. It is really very small in comparison with the gift that you have given to us. But help us to be faithful and to be cheerful givers. We pray and thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. I would also like to mention that in your program, it says a children's story is coming. That's not going to happen, nor is the lamb's offering. So if you have anything for the lamb's offering, put it in the baskets that are coming around at this point. This will be the one offering for the day.
Thank you. Now's the time when all of us will get to sing together with the orchestra. First hymn is Hark the Herald Angels Sing, number 122. Sing number 119, Angels from the Realms of Glory. There are four verses. Angels from the Realms of Glory, number 119.
Thank you.
was wonderful, hearing that big choir like you are out there. And now we're going to sing Good Christian Men Rejoice. Good Christians Now Rejoice, hymn number 136.
Thank you. Now the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise. When as his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Ghost. Then Joseph, her husband, being just a man and not willing to make her a public example, was minded to put her away privily. But while he thought on these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost.
And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. Now all this was done that it might be fulfilled which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us.
Then Joseph, being raised from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord had bidden him, and took unto him his wife, and knew her not till she had brought forth her firstborn son, and he called his name Jesus. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria, and all went to be taxed, everyone in his own city.
City of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she would be delivered.
Thank you.
She brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone around about them, and they were sore afraid.
And the angel said unto them, Fear not, For behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger.
And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace and goodwill towards men."
While we wait for our bass players to become trombone players, this is going to become a congregational song. So if you'll turn in your hymnals to number 142, we'll be singing verses 1, 2, and 4. 142, "Angels We Have Heard on High."
Pass as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord hath made known to us." And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in the manger.
when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all they that had heard it wondered at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen, as it was told unto them.
Now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he that is born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and have come to worship him." When Herod the king heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus is written by the prophet, 'And thou, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, art not the least among the princes of Judah, for out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule my people Israel.'"
Then Herod, when he had secretly called the wise men, determined from them what time the star appeared. He had sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the young child, and when you have found him, bring back word to me that I may come and worship him also." When they heard the king, they departed, and behold, the star which they had seen in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceedingly great joy. As the bells perform joy to the world, we invite you to join in song when you hear the piano begin to play.
And when they were coming to the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh. And being warned of God in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed into their own country another way.
Somehow.
Thank you.
faithful.
How wonderful. It seems like we can't stop praising the Lord, so we're going to continue singing, "Oh Come All You Faithful," hymn number 132. So I invite you to stand to sing this with us. "Oh Come All You Faithful." 132. Could you hold my book for me?
May be seated. This has truly been a blessing, has it not? What an opportunity. And we have several people who've put in a lot of time and effort, and we want to thank them. My wife, Julie, Daniel Cerna, and many others have put in a lot of time in preparation for this program. We also have with us some guests from the Summit High School. Can those from Summit High just wave your hands? All right. And so we're glad that they could come and join us as well. Before we finish our service, we have a special time that we're going to dedicate to pray for one of our dear friends here at Mentone, Dwayne Lemon. There you are, brother. If you'll just come down to the front. Dwayne is going to have a surgery here next week, and we want to have a special prayer for him. So, brother, we're glad you're here in town, and we just invite you to kneel down. We'll have a special prayer, and then after that, Pastor will have the closing benediction. Did you want to take just a couple seconds to mention your surgery?
Sure. It was only about a year and a half ago that a friend of mine had a portable echocardiogram with them and just said, "Hey, let me take a look at your heart and your wife's." And she said, "Oh, your left side of your heart looks really large." And she said, "You know what? I think you need to go see a cardiologist just to check it out. May not be nothing, but check it out." Fast forward a year and a half later, I saw my cardiologist, and when he saw it, he said, Dwayne, he says, you have a diseased mitral valve. It obviously was from rheumatic fever when I was a child. And all these decades, I've been living with a diseased mitral valve and didn't have a single symptom. Wow. He pointed me to a heart surgeon, and he said, you're going to need to talk to a heart surgeon about this. And when I talked with the heart surgeon, they fully agreed, you have severe regurgitation. If you don't address this soon, there are a lot of potential things that can happen. And through a series of providence, which is quite incredible, we have scheduled a surgery for December the 19th, which is this Monday. And we just solicit your prayers that by God's grace, this will be a very successful surgery. It is poised to be so. All the statistics and everything, they've checked me out. I was told that I have arteries of a 20-year-old athlete. That's, I think, what they said. To God be the glory for that. Amen. So they've looked at things, and they've said that this looks very, very positive. Anything can happen in surgery, as we know, friends, especially heart surgery. But nevertheless, we're looking up, we're staying positive, and I greatly solicit your prayers, and by God's grace, I'll be able to rise from the table on Monday to a speedy road to healing. Amen. To get back to God's work and God's business.
So we invite you, as we kneel in prayer, just to bow your heads as we conclude our service. Heavenly Father, we are so thankful that we can come to you in prayer. We want to thank you for this high Sabbath that we have enjoyed, but right now we want to pause to pray for our dear brother, Dwayne. We are so thankful for his ministry. You have done great things through your servant, and we pray that you will be with the surgeons and everyone attending this case on Monday, that you will work in a mighty way. We thank you again that we can trust you, for you are the master physician, and we trust his case into your care. Again, thank you so much. In Jesus' name, amen.
I'd like to invite you to stand now, and we'll close our service with a benediction. Father in heaven, as we close this service, we pray that it has been music to your ears, that you have accepted our offering of praise and thanksgiving for having sent Jesus into this world to die for our sins, to give us an example how to live. And as we conclude the service now, we pray that the blessing that you've given to us will remain with us, and that always in our mind we'll be reminded of that great gift, what it means to us, and of your soon coming in the clouds of glory. To this end, we pray in Jesus' name, amen.